Welcome. I am Dr. Thomas Gerber, one of the associate editors of Mayo Clinic Proceedings. To be more respectful of your time and your interests, I'll start separating my monthly multimedia summaries into different parts. In this first part, I will focus on the articles that our editor-in-chief, Dr. William Lanier, has selected as editor's choice and highlights for the May 2014 issue of our journal. This month's editor's choice is the original article, Long-Term Use of Zolpidem Increases the Risk of Major Injury, a Population-Based Cohort Study, by Dr. Ming-Mei Lai and colleagues from China Medical University and Hospital in Taichung, Taiwan. The authors found that long-term use of zolpidem is associated with a significantly greater risk of head injury or fracture requiring hospitalization than the risk that patients have who are not taking sedative hypnotic agents. The accompanying editorial, The Sirens of Sleep, was written by Dr. Timothy Morgenthaler from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Dr. Morgenthaler points out that in many cases, insomnia may be prevented or improved by attention to lifestyle and sleep habits. Cognitive behavioral therapy is a safe and effective method to improve sleep, but sadly often not available. One of this month's featured highlights is the original article, Serum Polyclonal Immunoglobulin-Free Light Chain Levels Predict Mortality in Chronic Kidney Disease, by Dr. Colin Hutchison from Hawke's Bay District Health Board in Hawke's Bay, New Zealand, and colleagues from several healthcare institutions in the United Kingdom. The authors found that polyclonal combined free light chain levels were independently associated with deaths from cardiovascular disease and infection. This implies that combined free light chains have potential as a biomarker by which patients with chronic kidney disease can be risk stratified for mortality. The second featured highlight in this month's issue is the review article, Contemporary Strategies in the Diagnosis and Management of Heart Failure, by Dr. Shannon Dunley and colleagues from Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. Here, the authors provide a thorough update on contemporary strategies in the diagnosis and management of heart failure, organized by heart failure stage A to D, that have emerged during the past several years. The third featured highlight in our May 2014 issue is the review article, Circumcision Rates in the United States, Rising or Falling? What effect might the new affirmative pediatric policy statements have? By Dr. Brian Morris from the University of Sydney in Sydney, Australia, and colleagues from several US healthcare institutions. The authors review that the prevalence of circumcision in males between 14 to 59 years increased 2.5% between 2000 and 2010, but neonatal circumcisions have declined 6% since the 1960s. They argue that public health policies should promote circumcision, focusing on population subgroups with lower circumcision prevalence. This concludes the first portion of my summary for May 2014.
We hope you found this presentation from the content of Mayo Clinic Proceedings valuable. Our journal's mission is to promote the best interests of patients by advancing the knowledge and professionalism of the physician community. If you are interested in more information about us, our homepage is www.mayoclinicproceedings.org. There you will find access information for our social media content, such as additional videos on our YouTube channel or journal updates on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter. More information about healthcare at Mayo Clinic is available at www.mayoclinic.com. This video content is copyrighted by Mayo Foundation for Medical Education and Research.